party spirit's in the air. 0 to 60, she's the next big bang. Tell me it's still. She's just a devil woman with evil on her mind. The whole world call me Hank.
He said, drifting, can you make folks cry when you play and sing? Have you paid your dues? Can you moan?
They decided to practice at home in the garage. And the drummer didn't show up, and my dad said, oh, told his compadre, pues la quita, Jaimito, you know. Let him, I don't know what quita. His compadre, his dad, compadre, was named Chema Sanchez. I still remember his name. And he said, sí. Bueno, pues ahí they're practicing. They did a little polquita, you know, I started, started playing. And I saw his face like, oh, sí, sí sabe música, you know. I said, ahora chotis, the style of chotis. And then I would play redoba or try to do a wapango. I was starting a little bit of wapango. And before you know it, that night, I heard my dad come by and say, acúpalo, acúpalo, let's hire him right now.
Now, when you were doing this with your dad, was their name Los Chamacos? Or?
No, back then, they didn't even have a name.
No?
They didn't have a name. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Now that we're talking so many years and stuff, and they really didn't have a name because it was just them. It was just him, my dad's company, and some other man would sing, and some other guy was playing the drums.
Okay.
They didn't have a name. Just, I want to ask my mom. She's still alive.
Yeah.
She knows what is the name.
Yeah, that'd be interesting because
Los Borrachos or something. My mom probably would say.
So you were like what, 8, 9, 10 years
no,
old?
No, I was by that time I was already. It's gonna be 7.
Okay.
7.
And they were already trying to draw on drums.
Wow. Well, yeah. So
you obviously had some sort of dawn, man. I mean, that's what they say. And I mean, you caught on to that quick because it's interesting because I had Jesse Turner here, and that's how old he was when he started doing that too. And then he went towards the accordion just like you did. It's very similar, man. It's
well, I
crazy.
Guess you know, like every kid, you know, you get I'm tired of playing the drums. I want to learn something else.
Mm-hmm.
But while you're playing the drums, you're hearing so many different instruments. You're hearing, you know, the bajo sexto, and then, of course, you got to follow the accordion, so you hear the accordion so much. The music is sticking in your head, whether you like it or not, you know, and that's where I was learning of liking polkas. I would hear polkas. I would love to play polkas, and I was listening to it, and before you know it, I said, man, the accordion seems like a really, really awesome instrument to learn.
So how long were you playing drums with your dad, man?
Well, I played drums with my dad, and I didn't get paid because they were family, you know. My dad said, you like toys.
No pagas renta, mijito.
That's right.
Hey, this is your rent.
Te gusta comer. But things like that, you know, I did it from 7, and we started playing in house parties.
Mm-hmm.
My mom was my roadie. She unloaded my drums and set them up for me and everything.
La chaperona.
That's right. And every weekend, so we did house parties. He played at night at the bars. House parties in like Saturday morning from 10 to 2. At night in the bars from 7 to 2. You know, every weekend until.
Dude.
I just told my dad, I was like, I guess 10 or 11. I told my dad, Dad, I want an accordion. Why don't you buy me an accordion? Comprame. My dad would say, that's loco. Como que just buy an accordion?
And he was a bajo sexto.
He played the bajo sexto. And not quinto, the 12 string, you know, original from Mr. Macias.
Yeah.
It was made in San Antonio.
Mm-hmm.
And, so I said, well, I want to learn the he says, you prove to me that you can play or learn something on the accordion, and I'll let you know. Well, every day I went to my dad's compadre's house, Chema Sanchez. He didn't live too far. So I started asking him, I want to learn the polquita. And he said, which one? I didn't know names, but I said, I would give him just you know, the money. He knew, oh, I thought the nickel polka.
Yeah.
And he would tell him, well, I'll show it to you. He showed it to me a few times, And I started catching on. I borrowed his accordion. I took it home. I practiced it all day, all evening. That's all my mom heard. I could hear it. Ya, hombre, ya, padre. You know, at one polka. I said, no, mom, I'm going to show dad when he gets home one day, you know. And we're practicing every day. So I really learned it pretty good, I would think. And then when he came home, he says, ayer, tu mamá dice que ya aprendiste una polquita. So I said, sure, dad. So I remember playing it. And I played the whole polka. Okay, Dad, I put it down. Okay, Dad, buy me an accordion. No. What do you mean, no? Just because you learn one polka, you think I'm going to buy you an accordion? Learn another one.
Mm-hmm.
I had to learn another one. About 5 or 6 to prove to him until I didn't know that my dad's going to buy it. I told him, your son, he has a good ear. He can catch on and hear and follow and learn, you know, the scales of the accordion without him even knowing what he's doing, because I didn't know. I just knew that I loved polkas and stuff. So I learned it, not realizing the polkas really were helping you learn the accordion. the scales on the accordion. If you want to learn the accordion, the good thing to learn first is polkas.
Man, you know what, man? I see the accordion, and to me, it seems like a difficult instrument to learn, bro. It doesn't seem that easy. You've pretty much mastered it, bro.
You know what helped a lot at the long time? Also, as my dad had Chema Sanchez playing with him, and then he would play with his other compadre, Ned Ponce. Mm-hmm. Ned Ponce was also an accordion player. Now, back then, I had to be 8 or 9, playing at Lucy's Lounge in Houston, Texas, on Quitman. This man was one of the first ones, see, they would pick up the accordion like this and play Viva Seguin, the whole polka, like that. Uh-huh. Just playing it like that. The whole polka, I was watching him play.
Bonion show.
He would. He didn't know. He just did it out of the blue, and he started doing little things like that. And I remember seeing things and at the time. So all those years that I played drums watching and experiencing with different accordion players that my dad had, he had Chema Sanchez, Ned Ponce, Mr. Vidal Jaime, these three accordion players that I remember growing up with and watching them play. And Vidal Jaime was another man that he recorded. He tuned accordions. You know, that's one thing I cannot figure out.
Yeah, there's some special people that have to do that, man.
That's special talent.
Yeah.
Like to think you get a, you know, you get the accordion, you get the readout, you start filing it.
Like a piano tuner, man. Yeah. You know, you don't find those
I
anywhere.
I tried that one time. I messed up my accordion really bad. But it's not that easy. But he would do it old school. Uh-huh. So they had these machines, but he would take it off. He put it in his mouth, blow it, and file it, and blow it, file it, and put it back on the accordion. And,
yeah.
And he would tune it really good.
That is a very, that is an art. That
That's
is an
talent,
art to
yeah,
do that.
Back then. So those three accordion players, I learned from them. I learned a lot from them.
So how long did you play with your dad, man?
I played with my dad all the years of being a drummer. To the age of at least 13 when he finally got me my first accordion.
Mm-hmm.
First accordion was, it was a little small Hohner, and it was a Corona too. And I played with it every day at home. I practiced and I was learning and listening to all kinds of music and stuff. And at that time, right around 14, my cousin David would hang out with me.
Mm-hmm.
You see, my cousin David and his dad, well, his dad owned a bar.
Yeah.
On the other side of Houston.
David Dianda is another artist that formed Excelencia and was part of Raul Dianda.
Yeah. Right. Los Chamacos de Raul Dianda.
And Raul Dianda, who's Raul Dianda? That's David's
that's my dad.
That's your dad then.
Yeah. Okay. It's his uncle.
Yeah. So then Raul Dianda was formed at, around what time? How old were you that happened?
Well, when he started coming around, my dad was still playing with another band called, I think it was Los Imperiales.
Mm-hmm.
Imperiales de Ted Morin, something like that. So David would hang out with us, and before you know it, he was getting interested in music. So he was learning the bass from the señor, Mr. Julian. His name was Julian also, un señor. And he didn't mind showing him the simple basic steps of, you know, primera, segunda, tercera. And he would learn pretty good the bass at the same time. So we're at home. Now we have a few instruments, you know, that my dad left his bajo there. I had accordion. And the señor would let him borrow the bass at home.
And
so
play around there?
We just played around. at the house, we just messing around, listening to music, and started playing music at the same time. Well, my oldest sister already by then had passed away. She was young. She loved to have a lot of kids. She wanted a big family, and they told her that she couldn't have too many kids. Well, she had three girls and one boy, just like my mom was one boy and three girls, and which is my nephew, Ruben Dianda. So he practically lived with us because when his mom passed away, my mom helped raise the grandkids.
Yeah, that happened a lot back in those days,
yeah,
man, you know?
Right? That's true.
Yeah, well, I mean,
everybody gets raised by grandma.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, who's your mom? No, grandma.
Yeah.
That's what you always hear. And it's so my mom raised my sister's kids, and my sister raised one of the other nieces. So Ruben was hanging out with us, and we didn't know that, and I forgot that his dad at the time was a bass player.
Mm-hmm.
He played bass. So he was already had talent inside of him that we didn't realize, because when we go see my dad, which is my brother-in-law, he would start playing bass with my dad also. So it was like pretty much family. So he left his bass there too. So my nephew Ruben, he was picking it up. And he was fast picking it up. We're messing around. Before you know it, David started grabbing the bajo.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just us three. He's playing the bajo, I'm playing the accordion. My nephew Ruben playing the bass. And we're just playing around, getting music together. And my dad would hear us and think, you know,
I got my band.
Golly, there's something going on.